Terry, since he was elected, Governor Scott Walker has been saying that his two-year budget plan will be painful, and tomorrow we'll find out exactly how painful.
The governor and his staff are not releasing many details about his budget plan in advance of Tuesday's address, but talking to reporters in La Crosse, Walker made it clear deep cuts are coming.
The budget I'll introduce tomorrow, there will be over $1 billion in cuts from aides from the state to the local governments. But there will be $1.44 billion worth of reductions in savings that these local governments will be able to achieve because of the budget repair bill.
Democrats say they haven't been briefed yet on the plan, but are expecting the budget to include massive cuts in state aid, meaning local governments will have to make tough decisions to balance their books.
I think we need 50,000 people here tomorrow for Scott Walker's budget, because it's going to hurt every single family and person in the state of Wisconsin.
On the eve of Walker's much-anticipated budget address, protests outside and inside the Capitol continues. The building was supposed to be cleared Sunday, but with hundreds of protesters refusing to leave, Capitol Police let them stay. The number of protesters have now dwindled to about 75. Police say until everyone leaves and allows the building to be fully cleaned, they will only let in a limited number of people. Protesters say that's a ploy to keep the public out during Walker's budget address.
The people that are here aren't leaving, and we're standing up for everyone else who's upset about this bill.
And to that point, the governor's office announced tonight that they will be limiting how many people will be allowed inside the Capitol tomorrow during the governor's budget address. However, exactly what that means is unclear, whether or not that means protesters will be kept out or if Walker's supporters will also be kept out. How many people will be let in? We're supposed to get a lot more of those answers tomorrow morning. Reporting live in Madison, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.